Hey everyone, welcome to my channel, where we explore sustainable living and travel. Today, we're diving into an incredible success story that's been unfolding in Ljubljana, the capital of Slovenia. Did you know that Ljubljana became the first European Union capital to commit to a zero waste goal in 2014, and that they are currently named as the number one green capital in the EU? Back in 2004, Ljubljana was far from the eco-friendly city it is today. They were generating about 280 kilograms of waste per person each year, with almost 100% of the waste being sent to landfill for incineration. Practically everything was either being buried or burned. Not exactly a model of sustainability. Fast forward to today, where their waste management tells a completely different story. Firstly, about 68% of their waste is recycled, which is impressive considering the European average is about 50%. And the US average is only 32%. Secondly, most of the remaining waste is either composted or converted into biogas for energy generation. Thirdly, only 5% of total waste ends up in landfills. This means that 95% of Ljubljana's waste is either recycled or repurposed, significantly reducing the city's environmental impact and creating valuable resources in the process. So, how do they manage such a dramatic turnaround? Well, it all comes down to three innovative approaches to waste management. 1. Waste separation and disposal. 2. Waste recycling and upcycling. 3. Public education. First, let's talk about what Ljubljana did for waste separation and disposal. One of the most innovative aspects of their waste management system is their underground collection units. These aren't your average dumpsters. We're talking about a high-tech, space-saving solution. When walking down the street, you'll notice some small collection units on the sidewalk. These are actually the access points to large underground containers, each holding up to 5,000 liters of waste. That's about 5 times the capacity of a standard above-ground container. There are 72 units across the city, making sure that there is a box accessible within 150 meters of any household. There are separate bins for residual waste, packaging, paper, glass, and organic waste. Each bin has an electronic identification system, and residents use cards to access them. This card is linked to your household, allowing the system to track how much waste each household is producing. The city can provide feedback to residents about their habits, and even implement incentive programs for those who reduce their waste or recycle more. Beyond tracking, the system has other benefits. It's more hygienic. The waste is stored underground, so it's reducing odors and keeps pests away. The system can alert waste management services when the containers are full, optimizing collection routes and frequencies. Now let's talk about their second strategy for recycling and upcycling their waste. It begins with their regional waste management center, also named as RCERO. It processes waste for a third of Slovenia's population and has the latest technology for waste treatment in Slovenia and Europe. What's particularly noteworthy is that RCERO was designed and built after Ljubljana committed to becoming a zero waste capital in 2014, showcasing the city's dedication to turning its ambitious goals into reality. One of RCERO's standout features is its biogas production. The facility uses anaerobic fermentation to break down organic waste, producing biogas in the process. This biogas is then converted into electricity and heat that powers about 10,000 households annually. That's a significant contribution to the local energy grid, all from waste that would otherwise end up in landfills. RCERO also has incredible recycling capabilities. They use advanced mechanical and biological treatment processes to handle mixed municipal waste. These include drum screens, magnetic separators, and even optical sorters that can differentiate between different types of plastic. This technology allows RCERO to recover a significant amount of recyclable materials and extend their lifetime use. Finally, the third strategy was all about public communication. The city shifted its focus from just promoting recycling to encouraging waste reduction and reuse. As we face global environmental challenges, cities like Ljubljana offer us a roadmap for creating more sustainable urban environments. It shows that with the right strategies, political will, and community engagement, changes are possible. Whether you're a city planner, a community leader, or just someone interested in sustainability, there's a lot we can learn from Ljubljana's example. Remember, every step towards reducing waste counts. It's not about being perfect. It's about making progress, one step at a time. Thanks for joining me on this exploration of Ljubljana's zero waste journey. It goes to show that with a little creativity and a lot of commitment, we can make our cities cleaner, greener, and more sustainable. Be sure to like and subscribe for more sustainable content. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.